I'm not gonna lie, I really outdid myself today. I had to make a client project portal because, well, I have clients now. I consult on Notion and I actually have people now. So, by the way, if you need help with Notion, just talk to me. I'm a decently nice guy to talk to. And I made something that I think might be one of my better projects of all time. So essentially, everyone needs a contacts database if they have clients, and they need to see a pipeline, and they also need those clients to see the work that they're doing. So when it comes to all that stuff, you need task management, project management, all in one, and you need a contact database all in one. So here's what you do. You can make a template that essentially has a CRM built out with a contact type, status, stage, all that kind of stuff. And then within it, it auto-populates in this template a project management database. So the way that this system works is essentially anytime you want to make a new project, you just create something like this and you select a project task. And all of this is formulated to have a task status that makes sense based off what you've gotten. So say you've gotten the assets and you got everything signed off on the project, cool. And then you have a timeline of 28 days. Awesome. So this is when your due date is. Perfect, easy, awesome. It went from planning to no deliverables because now we need to put deliverables in, which, as you'll see here in this below section, is filtered to have subtasks that are connected to this project. And the way that I did that is that you have the template have a relation to itself with a self relation, similar to how Thomas Frank's talked about it before. And if I make this example project, you'll see that I have a template here for deliverables as well. So all you'd have to do is make a deliverable that associates to project deliverable one. And then if I duplicate this a couple times, what you'll see is there's a progress bar associated to it. And if I check this off, it'll progress bar that thing based on the percentage of subtasks completed. And when I got some subtasks slash project deliverables put in there, this task status went from no deliverables to in progress. And then if I check another one off, it'll go farther. And if I check the last one off, it'll be completed here. It'll have a progress bar that is completed. Or if I undid that and I just wanted to override it because people finish stuff quickly and I'm just being quick with it, or if it didn't have any subtasks, you could override it to complete it. But I know there's often times when people have to get back to you on different assets. You know what? Waiting on. That's what that would showcase. Assets needed, waiting on. Or sometimes projects have to be archived because they just end. But they don't end in the way you'd like them to, so you want to save them. But you just archive them really quickly. And then that changes the task status. It changes the timeline. And this whole timeline situation is pretty self-explanatory too. If we have this August 15th due date, if we have this September 12th due date, we're still on time, we're not behind. But let's say we made it so that we got it then and it was a 2-day deadline. It would be due today. But let's say we got it here and it was a 2-day due date. It's late because it's August 13th right now. And then based off of when the due date is, if I check this off, you'll see that I have to put a completed time. So let's say I completed it on August 13th. I delivered it late. But what if I completed it here? It was on time. Or here, it was on time. This entire database system is going to showcase to clients exactly what they want to see. Whether the task is completed, how far along it is, when the due date is, are you on time? Are you waiting on something from me? What is it that you need from me? And you'll see that it is associated here in all of these different views. And the nice part about it is it has a easily created synced block system where it'll auto-populate all of these views. So this is client project portal. And then all you gotta do is make a quick sync block, copy the sync block, and go through all the different spots where it says paste sync block, copy a link to the sync block, and then you'll have a very easily accessible view for every single type of project too. And then in this main section, you'll have things like finished project showcase easily, or the assets to the project, whether that be contracts, invoices and financials, resource materials, which is all based off of an assets database that looks like this. It has multiple different types of assets where you have a URL spot or a file spot for the asset. It auto connects to a project that is within the template. So within the project template, it's just like the deliverables where if I make something here, it'll auto connect to this example project. So I can do invoice one. So then you can easily showcase back and forth between your client things that matter, like contracts and invoices, like, hey, we're on the same page. This is where we're at. And it's easily referable to you and the client. And then for them to see it and not have to interact with any of your other client stuff, all you have to do is share the client project portal page. rather than trying to make an entire new system outside of your CRM that you just relate to. It's within it. Perfect in that way. Now I'm going to do a quick view for all of you to look at these different formulas right here and right here and right here, just to get an idea if you understand anything about formulas, how this would work. Now this is going to be a paid template. It did take me a fair amount of work, and you'll see all the things below it as well. If you are someone who's serious about making your business a better and more usable thing in Notion, I'm happy to jump on a discovery call with you about this template or about building something custom for you, and they'll have a great understanding of how their project progress is going along just as you are interacting with it. And by sharing it just as a view or a comment option, you are not having anything interrupted by other clients. You will not have client seeing other client stuff. Now, so you know how the rest of the system works personally, when you go into and make a new client contact name, like let's do John Doe, you can pick this to be a current client that's already closed, right? But when you have somebody else that's new in the pipeline, you can add leads just like this. Example, lead Jane Fonda. And then here you can bring the person through this different pipeline. And you'll see here when I made John Doe that was an active client, in this section for the sync block you can make for yourself to put into all of these different ones. This is essentially so that you can easily navigate the system. You put this in here, copy this link to one of the views here, and then you make another sync block as we showed earlier. The nice thing about this, a client would not see this because you made it outside of their shared ability. The first sync block made is hierarchical top one, which means if you're putting it into somebody else's workspace after it was made in yours, they don't have the view permissions of it. So you can put a synced block really easily to get back into that section. And if you want to navigate this system easier, I would recommend going to the layout here and pressing open pages in full page so that you can easily just interact like this. And then if you want to go back to the homepage, use that sync block to come back. And this stuff's filtered here so that the active clients show up. So say you just want to go between different clients that are active. Once again, you can change that from side peek by here to go to layout, open pages and full page. And then it's an interactive system. So like, let's say I had a second new client where I make the contact clients and then it's a current clients closed. I go in here, I paste that sync block from earlier. Now I can go between all of these different clients really easily. And the great part about it is the fact that this is going to filter out so that when we have this new client become an old client, obviously the name wouldn't change. Let's do like Rick, big guy. Then you'll see here, they're no longer an active client, so they won't show up there. And when we go back to the main section, they're not longer an active client. They won't show up there, but they will be in the all contact section and they will still be in the closed section or the lost section from both ways. If you want to see more templates like this or more tips on how to improve your productivity, check out this video right here.